Today's readings are powerful images that challenge us in our attitude about other people. How are we to look at others when they fall short of their vocation in life? How are we to look at others when they hurt us? When they hurt people who don't deserve to be hurt? When they punish people who don't deserve to be punished? How do we look at them? There's two postures that I see in today's gospel. The first is that of the woman coming in to find the Lord. Now, she saw in herself her own shortcomings. She knew she had been doing some things that were wrong. We don't know what those things were, but the gospel tells us these things. She didn't need anyone to remind her. She knew well herself. But something happened to her where she became convinced that this man, Jesus, knew these things about her and loved her anyhow. And so she did whatever it took to find him. And when she hears that he's in a certain house, she breaks the door down, literally. Goes in crying and anticipates the act that Jesus himself will do at the Last Supper. Washing feet. But this time, not with water, but with the tears of her own sorrow for the mistakes she's made, for the ways she's perhaps hurt others or herself, people in her lives. And these tears cleanse not only the feet of the Lord, but her own heart, her own life. And as she shows this great love to the Lord, we're encountered with the other posture, that of Simon, who was hosting this dinner, who knew this woman. And because he says to himself, if this Jesus knew who this woman was, he would know she's a sinner. So Simon knew she was a sinner. Simon knew that she was hurting people, and he did nothing about it, except to turn away from her and to condemn her. This was his attitude towards this person, was to condemn the sinner. Meanwhile, Jesus points out, like someone, two people who are in debt, one who owes 2 years of their salary and one who owes only a month's worth of their salary to the same creditor. And that the one who has the larger debt is more grateful to be forgiven. And the one who had the smaller debt may never pay it off. They may never be even aware that they owe anything because it's just a small debt. It's the attitude we have about our own sin when we condemn others. We see the speck in our brother's eye, but not the wooden beam protruding out of our own. And this is a dangerous attitude that human beings, no matter what faith they are, no matter if we come to church every Sunday, if we're not careful, we too can have this attitude. But Jesus came to set us free, to engage in a ministry of forgiveness. He came so that anyone who has a debt to anyone else can be forgiven. Could you imagine if all of your creditors called you today and said, hey, great news, the house is paid off. No more mortgage payments. The car is paid off. the debt from their credit card bills wiped away, student loans, a thing of the past. I won't make any jokes there. All of your debts are forgiven. How happy would you be? You would rejoice. You would be so glad. Well, we have the same opportunity with God. And we ourselves are called to extend that same opportunity for others. For each one of us has been hurt by someone or another in life. And we have the chance to be that creditor who is going to call these people and to say, the debt is forgiven. The price has been paid. Because I love you. And I want love to be what defines this relationship, not sin. When we allow sin to define ourselves or others, we're allowing that spirit of evil to define our lives, our relationships. And it is not necessarily the case that because we show forgiveness, that we're showing weakness. It is the case, when done properly, and forgiveness can be done properly and improperly, that we are showing God's strength. That we are showing God's love and God's holiness. And this is the power that changes the world. Anything else is a spiritual power that will be held against us until we're ready to let it go. So whether you owe 2 years worth of your salary to God or someone else, or even just one day, the difference is the same. The more we are forgiven, the more we will love. The more we love, the more we will forgive. And this is our challenge today. And certainly, in light of these violent actions this weekend in our own fair city, where some people believe it is appropriate to destroy human beings for one reason or another, there is no reason ever to justify the destruction of innocent life. No reason whatsoever. But at a moment like this, we must guard and watch our hearts and minds carefully so that we do not participate ourselves in a spirit of evil, in a spirit of self-righteous indignation or condemnation, but that we would engage with a spirit of truth and justice. The Spirit of Christ, who knew the evils of the world and himself was crucified, himself chose to have nails driven through his own hands and feet so that the price would be paid and that every debt could be forgiven. My brothers and sisters, this is our choice. The way of forgiveness and love, or the way of punishment and death. There is a great difference between the two ways. Oh, that we all would choose wisely.